Hi, I'm Carrie. I'm the host of Best of Us in Retirement. I'm 77 years old, and I've learned a lot in my 77 years. And I want to share with you what I call my eight life lessons. There's two more than I had thought. I wish I could say I learned these life lessons early on and I benefited from them and they helped me achieve what I wanted to achieve. But the reality is I didn't learn these life lessons until my much later years. But I did feel that I wanted to share them with people, so I wrote a book about it. I actually wrote a book to discover who I was, because that was one of my lessons. The first lesson that I learned was, and again, I didn't learn it early on enough, was to discover my passion, to really figure out what it is I love to do and where I got excitement out of life and where I gained pleasure from life. I needed to find out what was going to make me happy. And in order to do that, I had to discover who Carrie was. And I did a exercise where I went back and examined the early years of my life, and I discovered that Carrie was formed in the first 14 years of his life. And those 14 years established what he could and couldn't do and what his passion really was. So I wrote a book, and that's what the first section of this book is about, my discovery process. And I wrote that in that format so that you would not only know who I am, but see how I discovered who I was, and maybe you could follow that same path. The second part of the book is then about what I learned from what I discovered I was. So number one was discover my passion and do what I wanted to do. Number two is to believe in myself. I discovered in my journey that I had an unwanted roommate. I had someone who lived in my head, and I had 90% of my daily conversations with, who told me I couldn't, I shouldn't, you'll never achieve that. This was the person who held me back, and they held me back for a big part of my life. But I discovered who they were and why they were who they were, and I ejected them. I ejected my unwanted roommate. Once you do that, you learn that you don't need to settle for less. You can have whatever you want because you believe in yourself. And you are what sets the limits on yourself, not anyone else. You set those limits. No one says, Carrie, you can't achieve that. You decide that. And once I was able to get rid of that, I had no bounds. Never stop learning. This is something I learned again in my later years, that if I would continue to learn, I could be better than anybody else because everybody else quit learning. I asked someone, a number of people, I asked, how many nonfiction books have you read since you graduated from your highest degree of education? And most of them say, no, I read fiction. No, nonfiction is where you gain knowledge, where you learn about the best things that will help you achieve what you want to achieve. It always caused me a laugh to hear that Warren Buffett would sell a lunch and people would pay up to millions of dollars to have a two-hour lunch with him. But he wrote a number of books that all sell for under $30. So you don't need to spend $30 million to get inside Warren's head. You could probably do it for under $100. So learn. Continue to educate yourself. Understand how money works. That's number four. I didn't. I was raised as a baby boomer, and I understood that my job was to create cash flow, to keep money coming through the door so that we could buy more stuff, so that we could live a better life. Well, what was a better life? A bigger house, a nicer car, better vacations, better clothes, better haircuts, you know, everything that I could accumulate in stuff. I got involved in art. I got involved in learning about wines and eating good food. Now, I enjoy all those things, but I did ever learn how to generate wealth. I never learned until my latter years that, in fact, even though I was a financial advisor, I had the privilege, if I chose to take ownership of some of the best companies in the world, to be partners with some of the smartest people in the world. This was a privilege that I had, and I could do it by investing. So I was financially illiterate, and to some degree, I was financially illiterate even when I was a financial advisor. I also understand now, number five, is you only get to go around once. You only get to go on this journey once. So you need to get rid of any bad relationships as soon as they establish themselves. I see some young people who get involved with the wrong people, and that's who you become. You will become the five closest friends, the people that you spend time with. So if they aren't good people, get away from them, and you go become a good person. You become who you play with. I remember that, and I look back at my childhood. Yeah, I became who I played with. So play with better people. Then focus on one thing. That's number six, my life lesson. Focus on one thing, and then just become very good about it. Study it, read, and learn. Whether it's finances, whether it's you want to be the best fisherman, whether you want to be the best sports figure, or you want to be a creator, just make your decision. You want to focus on one thing, and you want to become the best at it. And then, as I said in the other, in number three, never stop learning about it. Every day, read something about your passion. That was number one, that you want to focus on your one thing and become the best guy in the room of it. I like to think of it about life as a poker table. You know, if you've ever been to Las Vegas, you go into that back room and there's 10 guys sitting around a poker table. Well, you better be the smartest guy at the table or they're going to beat you. And you can become the smartest guy at the table. You find your passion. If it's poker, okay. But become the smartest guy at it. If you'll do that, everything else will fall into place. Everything else will become available to you. Then part of focus is become relentless. That's a chapter in this book. What that means, don't give up. Just keep working at it. And recognize that most people put in an 8-hour day. So don't put in an 8-hour day. Put in a 10-hour day. Put in a 12-hour day. Get up early in the morning and think. And read and think about your one thing and how you can become the smartest guy in the room. If you'll do that, you will be the smartest guy in the room because most people don't play the game that way. Take care of your body. You only get one. And take care of it from the very early on. I hope some young people find this video. Don't smoke. Don't do drugs. Don't put evil things in your body. Don't give overweight because your body is built to basically live in the desert and feed off the land. So feed off the land and keep yourself trim and fit. And then you won't have to deal with the many physical ailments that most people deal with in their older age. Don't ever take up a posture of sitting on the sofa, eating Twinkies and drinking Coke, watching daytime TV. Get up and get some exercise. I take this every day, M&M. It gives me energy. I'm 77 years old. And when I get done with this video, I'll go run 2 miles in the park. And I'll come home sweaty and stinky, and I'll have a level of energy that you won't believe. Before I did this, I had to talk myself into working out. Now MNMN, and there's a link to the to it in the description. It changed my life. I wouldn't take a day without it. Is it expensive? It ain't cheap. Ask for help. Have you ever had anybody walk up to you and say, excuse me, could you help me? What do you say? How do you feel? You say, sure, what can I do? How do you feel after you help them? Good about yourself. So give other people the privilege of helping you. I learned that again after a long, hard life. The people want to help you, particularly if they're your friends, particularly if they're your spouse. Ask your spouse, can you help me with this? Nita and I, just last night, I've written a number of books. Some of them are still on my computer. One of them I figured out I wrote in 2012. It was still on my computer. I said, Nita, this is the follow-up to Tall Grass. Tall Grass was the first book I read about the first 14 years of my life. My mother died young and I had some difficult times. And then the next one, which I call on paper, Grasshopper, I said, I wrote in 2012. Last night I got it out and I brought it to her and I said, would you read this? And then would you help me finish it? Would you help me? And she teared up. She said, what do you want me to do? I said, I want you to read it, and then I want you to contribute to it, and I want you and I to become published authors. I want you and I to tell people about our lives. And she said, do I have to use my real name? No, no you don't. But ask people for help. Go to your spouse and give them a challenge and say, hey, why don't we do this together? I need your help. And see how your life changes. Then work from a plan. That's my number eight. I use Excel spreadsheets. I love to say, if I do this and this and this and this happens, what are the next end results going to be? And then I create a spreadsheet and I then put in the variables. And then the variables I project out into the future. And then I come to it almost on a daily basis and update it. And I do that for this YouTube channel. If I make so many videos, how many clicks will I get? And how many new subscribers will I get? And what will that grow to? And if it grows in January at this rate and February at this rate, then how big will it be in March? And how big will it be 12 months from now? I have a plan. I know where I'm going. And I know how I'm going to get there. And I follow my life lessons. I'm relentless. I know my passion. I'm a creator. That's my passion. What's what I love to do? I believe in myself. I got rid of that roommate. And my coach lives up there. My coach wakes me up at about 6 o'clock every morning and says, this is what we're going to do today, Gary. These are the videos we're going to make. Let's go do it. I read every day. I'm dyslexic, so I don't like to read, but I write books. But I've learned on my computer, I can go to the Wall Street Journal and find the article I want to read, and I can click a button and it'll read it to me. And then I read along with it. And so I've overcome my dyslexia. I understand how money works. I invest every day. I take care of myself. I know I only go around once, and I know the people around me are the most important to me. I lost one of them that was extremely important, so I know what it is. I only focus on one thing, and that is my passion, creating. And then I'm relentless about it. I bore so many people. Sit down to lunch with them and start talking about the one thing that I'm focused on. And I ask people for help. I've just learned to do that. I just did it last night. And I think it's going to make my life much better. And I work from a plan. I hope this helps you. I hope it helps you focus. And do me a favor. Share it with your grandkids. Share it with your children. See if we can't together help them learn from our lessons in life? Hell, we're here just once. Why don't we try to make the world a better place while we're here for the people who follow us? And all we've got to do is help them and ask them to help us. Okay, those are my life lessons. I hope they help you. I'd encourage you to get rid of that roommate in your head. That is a big, big step. And read my book, learn how I did it, and you'll make me very happy. Thanks.